The test worked. We are good to go. Okay. Hi, Matt. The in-house. Yep. That was the warm-up. Gotcha. All right. Hi, I'm Matt, the in-house Rickroll-ologist here at Red Pepper. And welcome to another WFH edition of Do Not Touch on Tech, where we cover the latest in emerging technologies. So, have you just been on so many Zoom meetings and they're starting to become repetitive and sort of boring? Well, recently a service came out called Invite Rick that lets you go on over and send a Rick roll straight to your meeting. I'm gonna give you one, never gonna let you down, never gonna run around and desert you, never gonna make you cry. Never gonna give you one, never gonna let you down. But sadly, after 2 days and over 2,100 Rick rolls, we were shut down. Yes, we did this. Don't tell our moms. We ricked and we rolled and we got in trouble because we got the nicest cease and desist letter we've ever received. And therefore, bye, Rick, for now. Speaking of smiles, a Twitter user named Andrew Hung has created an AR app, that's an augmented reality app, that overlays everyone's face with a smile, whether they want to be smiling or not. It uses facial recognition to detect a face in the frame and then uses a technology similar to deepfakes where it replaces your sad face with a smiley face. 2020 just turned around. Everybody's smiling. What a great time to be alive. Recently, we talked about a technology called taste-o-vision, at least that's what we called it, where you can lick a screen and it actually tastes like things. Well, now there's taste-o-robot. They figured out how to make robots out of gelatin. It's a great way to administer drugs to animals that are afraid of people stuffing pills in their throats. And you just put the medicine inside these gelatin little robots and then send them out into the cage and let the animal eat the whole robot. This sounds terrible. So with people working more remote now, things like VR are just gonna become more and more popular and become more and more useful in day-to-day life. Currently, it's a little bit weird when you see somebody in VR because they don't look quite like themselves. Well, Facebook Reality Labs has come up with a way to actually map your real face to your avatar and map your real body movements to your avatar's character. So the eyes blink and the mouth moves and it looks just like you in VR. So next time when you're in VR and you walk in and you see Tony the Tiger and Stay Puft Marshmallow Man and Super Mario sitting around the table doing their fiscal plans and reports about Q4, and you walk in looking just like yourself, they're going to be so jealous, and they're going to be like, oh, that's you, Matt, because it looks just like you. So do you need a win this summer? Well, Michael Rechtin has figured out a way to make that win come to you repeatedly, over and over and over. You just get to win at cornhole as much as you want. But he takes a camera, attaches it to the board, uses some computer vision to detect where the bag is in the air, and then with some little servo robot motors, it'll adjust the board. So let's say this technology was built into your hamper. You just toss up your sweatpants. All of a sudden, they just land in that hamper. You could just throw them up anywhere in the house and the hamper would just run after them. Well, that's it for another edition of Touch on Tech. Thanks for coming by and spending some time with us. And we hope to see you next time on another edition of Touch on Tech.